Hi there, how are you doing? Welcome back to English Simplified channel. As we had already discussed what experimental research is, and one of its type that is pre-experimental, so in this session we are discussing its second type, that is quasi-experimental research design. In order to understand this easily, so I divide the discussion into A. What is quasi-experimental? B. When is it used? C. How is it applied? D. What are its types and how its data is analyzed? Well, are you ready? Let's get started. Part A. What is quasi-experimental? Like a true experiment, a quasi-experimental design aims to establish a cause and effect relationship between an independent and dependent variable. However, unlike a true experiment, a quasi-experiment does not rely on random assignment. Instead, subjects are assigned to groups based on non-random criteria. So, in conclusion, thus quasi-experimental research is research that resembles experimental research, but is not true experimental research. Because it doesn't use random assignment, in which it is a way of placing participants from your sample into different treatment groups using randomization. As you have to know, a true experimental should apply random sampling and random assignment in selecting the sample. Random sampling, also called probability sampling or random selection, is a way of selecting members of a population to be included in your study. While you use random assignment to place participants or sample into the control or experimental group. In fact, in quasi-experimental, these procedures aren't applied, that's why it's named as quasi-experimental design. Well, now let's continue to part B. When is quasi-experimental used? Quasi-experimental design is most useful in situations where it would be unethical or impractical to run a true experiment. In other words, quasi-experiments are most likely to be conducted in field settings in which random assignment is difficult or impossible. Bear in mind, quasi-experimental has two groups of sample, namely control and experimental groups, but these sample aren't selected by random sampling and random assignment. As I have already mentioned it before. Alright, and this is part. See, how is quasi-experimental applied? As there are some types of quasi-experimental, and the way they are applied is different for each type. Then, to answer this question, we have to discuss it type by type. And continue to the next part, that is part D. What are its types and how its data is analyzed? Well, the types of quasi-experimental are such as 1. Post-test only non-equivalent groups design. 2. Pre-test-post-test non-equivalent groups design. 3. Interrupted time series design with non-equivalent groups. 4. Pre-test-post-test design with switching replication. And 5. Switching replication with treatment removal design. All right, let's see one by one. Number 1. Post-test only non-equivalent groups design. In this design, participants in one group are exposed to treatment, a non-equivalent or control group is not exposed to the treatment, and then the two groups are compared. What does this mean? Let's see the procedure. Post-test only non-equivalent groups design has two groups of sample, they are experimental and control groups. Treatment is only given to the experimental group, or the control group is with no treatment. After that, the two groups are tested, which is called post-test. So it means there is only post-test in this design, or this design is without pre-test. Then finally, the data is analyzed by comparing the post-test of the two groups. Now let's see and discuss the second type of quasi-experimental, that is 2. Pre-test-post-test non-equivalent groups design. In a pre-test-post-test design, the dependent variable is measured once before the treatment is implemented, and once after it is implemented. Let's see its procedure. This design also has two groups of sample, they are control and experimental groups. The first step is to address pre-test to the two groups. Then it is continued by giving the treatment to only experimental group. Having finished giving the treatment, then the two groups are tested once again with what it's called post-test. And to make the conclusion, then the data is analyzed by comparing the mean of the post-test of the two groups, or by statistical analysis of t-test. Okay, now we're discussing the third type of quasi-experimental, that is, 3. Interrupted time series design with non-equivalent groups. A variant of the pretest-posttest design is the interrupted time series design. A time series is a set of measurements taken at intervals over a period of time. In addition, the interrupted time series design with non-equivalent groups involves taking a set of measurements at intervals over a period of time, both before and after an intervention of interest in two or more non-equivalent groups. Let's see how it is done or applied. The first step is to give pretest to the two groups. Then treatment is given. Here, you have to know, the treatment given is by some periods of time, as in this example, treatment is given each week for 6 months to the experimental group, while the control group doesn't receive the treatment. After that, the two groups are post-tested. And finally, the data is analyzed to draw the conclusion. Well, the next type of quasi-experimental is pretest-posttest design with switching replication. In pretest-posttest design with switching replication, it's done by using a pretest-posttest design with switching replication design. Non-equivalent groups are administered a pretest of the dependent variable, then one group receives a treatment, while a non-equivalent control group does not receive a treatment. The dependent variable is assessed again, and then the treatment is added to the control group, and finally, the dependent variable is assessed one last time. Okay, let's see its procedure. The first step is by addressing pretest to the two groups. Then treatment is firstly given to the experimental group, while for the control group is held off. After that, the two groups are post-tested. Then, the treatment is given to the control group. After giving it, the control group is again post-tested. And finally, the conclusion is made by comparing and analyzing the data. And now we have come to last type of quasi-experimental, that is switching replication with treatment removal design. In a basic pretest-posttest design with switching replication, the first group receives a treatment, and the second group receives the same treatment a little bit later on, while the initial group continues to receive the treatment. All right, let's see its procedure. This design at least has two phases. For example, a research is conducted in two phases in 2 weeks. So, in phase 1 and week 1, both the experimental and control groups are pre-tested. Then the treatment is firstly given to the experimental group, while for the control group is held off. After that, the two groups are tested again with a test, namely post-test. Then finally, the data is analyzed and saved. Next, in phase 2 week 2, the treatment is stopped for experimental group, while a control group is now receiving the treatment. After the treatment is done for the control group, again the two groups are post-tested. And finally, the data is analyzed to draw the conclusion. All right. Now let's make the conclusion and summary. 1. A quasi-experiment is a type of research design that attempts to establish a cause and effect relationship. The main difference with a true experiment is that the groups are not randomly selected and assigned. 2. There are 5 types of quasi-experimental designs that are between subjects in nature. They are 1. The post-test only non-equivalent groups design. 2. The pretest-post-test design with non-equivalent groups. 3. The interrupted time series design with non-equivalent groups. 4. The pretest-post-test design with switching replication. And 5. The switching replication with treatment removal design. In post-test only non-equivalent groups design has 2 groups of sample. They are experimental and control groups. Treatment is only given to the experimental group, or the control group is with no treatment. After that, the two groups are tested, which is called post-test. So it means there is only post-test in this design, or this design is without pretest. 2. The pretest-post-test design with non-equivalent groups. This design also has 2 groups of sample. They are control and experimental groups. The first step is to address pretest to the two groups. Then it is continued by giving the treatment to only experimental group. Having finished giving the treatment, then the two groups are tested once again with what it's called post-test. and to make the conclusion, then the data is analyzed by comparing the mean of the post-test of the two groups, or by statistical analysis of t-test. 3. The interrupted time series design with non-equivalent groups. The first step is to give pretest to the two groups. Then treatment is given. Here, you have to know, the treatment given is by some periods of time, as in this example, treatment is given each week for 6 months to the experimental group, while the control group doesn't receive the treatment. After that, the two groups are post-tested. And finally, the data is analyzed to draw the conclusion. 4. The pretest-posttest design with switching replication. The first step is by addressing pretest to the two groups. Then treatment is firstly given to the experimental group, while for the control group is held off. After that, the two groups are post-tested. Then, the treatment is given to the control group. After giving it, the control group is again post-tested. Then finally, the conclusion is made by comparing and analyzing the data. And the last type is, number 5. The switching replication with treatment removal design. This design at least has two phases. For example, a research is conducted in two phases in 2 weeks. So, in phase 1 and week 1, both the experimental and control groups are pre-tested. Then the treatment is firstly given to the experimental group, while for the control group is held off. After that, the two groups are tested again with a test, namely post-test. Then finally, the data is analyzed and saved. Next, in phase 2 week 2, the treatment is stopped for experimental group, while the control group is now receiving the treatment. After the treatment is done for the control group, again the two groups are post-tested. And finally, the data is analyzed to draw the conclusion. Well, that's it our discussion relating to quasi-experimental research design. Hopefully, this explanation has broadened your knowledge. As we have already covered pre-experimental research design and quasi-experimental research design, then, our next topic of discussion will be true experimental research design and factorial design. By the way, don't forget to support my channel by your subscribe. Thanks and ta-ta.